largest cities in the world. All right, here we go. We're zooming in on the British Isles. We're going to start with the smallest city in the world and gradually work our way up. And here it is, Vatican City. The smallest city slash country in the world. Look at that plane. This country is so small, there literally is nowhere to park a plane. That's how we see it. 825 population. Okay, here we go. Next up, we have quite the upgrade. 500,000 people live in Tanta, Egypt. And do you know what? 500,000 people in that area compared to 800 people in that area. That just shows you Tanta's very small and they are really crammed in there. And then look at Bristol from the United Kingdom in comparison. 680,000 people live in that whole area. Okay, and look how much greener it is compared to Tanta. And then after that, we've got Hong Kong, which is a very interesting shape because it's along the coast. But 7 million people live in that whole area, so people are pretty tightly packed in Hong Kong as well. After Hong Kong, the next biggest city is Vienna, Austria, or Wien, Österreich, as they say in Deutschland, with 1 million people there, followed by Maputo in Mozambique with 2 million people, and then Casablanca. That is such a cool sounding place. But yeah, it is interesting seeing the size of the cities not necessarily correlating with the amount of people that live there. We've got the capital of Denmark, Copenhagen, with 1 million people, and then Addis Ababa in Ethiopia. I love seeing the interesting shapes. This one looks like a fish. Baghdad looks like a fish. This is the fish's nose. There's his like top fins and there's his tail. That's a fish. The animations that Metaball Studios do are always absolutely amazing, by the way. Look at the river. That looks so cool. And look at the clouds and everything. Then we've got Brussels, Belgium with 1 million people, and then Nairobi, Kenya with 6 million people, 851,000 kilometers squared. That is a lot. Then we have Lima in Peru. That's the capital of Peru, I think, with 9 million people. And you can see how hot and arid it is in that area. Then we've got Lisbon, Portugal with 2 million people and almost 1 million kilometers squared. Oh, Budapest, very close to 1 million kilometers squared as well. Lots and lots of fields in Budapest by the looks of things. And then we've got Abu Dhabi, which looks so different to Budapest. That's in the United Arab Emirates. And just, look at the comparison. It's so interesting seeing like the deserty sand and the super straight roads compared to the European like fields. But yeah, if you're comparing this to Vatican, we have had such a huge increase. Then we've got Santiago in Chile and Madrid in Spain. Madrid actually smaller than I thought. Now, I actually am not 100% sure what the largest city in the world is. I think I saw in one of my previous YouTube comments that it is Japan, but we shall see. And it will be interesting when they zoom out and compare them all. But we've also got Istanbul from Turkey. United Arab Emirates popping up for the second time in this video. And you can see very similar terrain in both areas. Then we've got Ho Chi Minh City. I am going to mispronounce so much. And then it's London. Is that Greater London or is it just Central London? I think that's Greater London. Oh my God. I've just seen what they've done. Look, they've lined London up with the actual map in the background. So you can see the River Thames actually continues outwards. Ah, very nice, Metaball Studios. And then we've got Milan, which I don't remember being next to London, but there it is. 4 million people live there. And you can see we've gotten pretty large through there. And then we've got Rio de Janeiro with 12 million people living there. Sydney, Australia. I've been to that one as well. Where's the Sydney Opera House? I can't see it from here. We're way too far zoomed out. Then we've got Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia. We're getting to some really, really huge areas now. And then Delhi in India, which I know is massive. Toronto, Canada. Only 6 million people live there. Delhi has 29 million. Mexico City has 20 million. And then Toronto, which is a similar size to both of them, only 6 million people. It's so interesting seeing such differences. And I love seeing all the shapes as well. Then we've got Paris, France. Oh, look at that meander. That river looks insane. And then we've got Seoul, Incheon from South Korea. 21 million people live there. 2,700 kilometers squared. Sao Paulo in Brazil. That looks huge. That looks absolutely massive. And that looks pretty densely populated as well with 22 million. All right, where are we heading now? We're zooming on around. Oh, is it Buenos Aires? Yes, it is. Buenos Aires, Argentina. 3,000 kilometers squared. And then Jakarta, which I know is absolutely huge as well. 34 million people living in Jakarta. That's a big increase compared to the surrounding cities that we're looking at right now. Shanghai. Then we've got Beijing. Then we've got Guangzhou, Foshan. And then we've got Dallas-Fort Worth. That's absolutely massive. I assumed it'd just be all the Asian countries from this moment forward. But Dallas in Texas is absolutely ginormous. And look at the roads. It's so interesting seeing how square the road layout is in the US. Like, you can see, even from this great distance, that it's just built up with tiny little squares, whereas areas like Beijing, it's a lot more kind of circular and just working its way outwards like this. Oh, there's quite a lot of US places. We've got Philadelphia, we've got Washington, and then Moscow, capital of Russia's jumping in. That's crazy. All right, where are we heading? Where are we heading? Los Angeles. Okay, yeah, it makes sense that we've not seen that one yet. Oh, we are so far out now that we can actually see the curvature of the earth as we take a look at Chicago and Atlanta. I'll tell you what, USA absolutely dominating this list. USA is way too big. And then we've got Tokyo. Is that the final one? I think it is. No, it isn't. We've got Boston Province, USA. Slightly bigger. 9,500 kilometers squared compared to Tokyo's 8,000. So Tokyo isn't the biggest city. Is that it? That's them all. That's them all. And then from there, you can see just how big we've actually gone when you take a look at Abu Dhabi, which is a massive place in comparison to Boston there. I want to see teeny weeny little Vatican. Where's teeny weeny little Vatican? We're zooming out. Hold it. Hold it. I think that's it there. Do you know what? I don't think we can even see it. I think that's the Egyptian place. And then that tiny little pixel that you can just see. I think that is Vatican City. Oh my God, wait. I didn't even look at the biggest city. It's New York. I was so excited to see Vatican again that I missed New York with 12,000 kilometers squared. So apparently that is the biggest city in the world after Boston and then Tokyo. Oh, look at them all. That is beautiful. They have completely filled the entire British Isles. Incredible. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe if you've not already. Let's get to 1 million subscribers. Link to Metaball Studios at the top of the description, and I'll see you all later.